battered and bruised, but not broken. A 78-year-old woman who survived a home invasion tells us what happened in her home Tuesday morning and why she's staying somewhere else for now.
I'm scared to come back until they arrest the guy.
Well, first at 5, the hunt to find the person who did this to her. Good evening. I'm Melissa Fry.
I'm Adrian Whitsett. Omaha police tell us there is a warrant out right now for a 16-year-old boy in connection with this attack.
And Janet Jordan tells us police tracked him down using fingerprints taken from her home. But she has no idea who it was who broke into her home in the Deer Park neighborhood just north of Interstate 80. And we were there as she returned for the first time to a home she's lived at for the past 32 years.
Here's KETV News Watch 7's Chin Doan with a story you'll see only on 7.
I've never been beaten like this in my life.
Beaten, bruised, and terrified. Janet Jordan stops by her home after nearly 2 days in the hospital. The 78-year-old tells us what happened at her house early Tuesday morning. She says it started with a noise at her front door. As she opened the door, an intruder kicked it in.
And that pushed me back. And he started beating me with that. They said it was a table leg.
Jordan begged him to stop. She says he was after her TV, but he broke it during the attack and left her so bloody she could barely call for help.
The blood was coming so bad I couldn't hardly dial the phone because the phone was getting bloody.
This great-great-grandmother is thankful she wasn't more seriously hurt, but she says some things will need more time to heal, like the fear she now has being back inside her home.
See, I think the night's what's going to bother me. If I hear any noise, I'm going to be traumatized again for a while.
But she has learned a lesson, something she wants to pass on to everyone else in her neighborhood.
Keep your blinds closed. Don't open the door to nobody. Don't trust nobody.
Jordan's road to recovery is not over yet. She still has to get stitches removed and also a CT scan for the bleeding in her brain. Coming up tonight at 10, we'll have tips on how to stay safe and how to avoid becoming a victim in a home invasion. In Omaha City, Councilman Gary Gernant is one of Janet Jordan's neighbors. He's lived in that area for 67 years, says he can't believe someone attacked her. He's known her and the neighborhood for quite a while.
It is tragic that we have assaults that take place, you know, whether they're a misdemeanor or felonious. You know, we've had both of those happen in our area, and neighborhoods need to pay attention to those. Neighbors constantly have to be vigilant, and if there's something that just doesn't look right in your neighborhood, report it.
Councilman Gernant also told us the Deer Park neighborhood already has people patrolling. They're now considering phone alerts as well.